With each class of organic compounds that we encounter, one of the important skills that we'd like you to have is to be able to name those compounds using the IUPAC system. Here we take up the aldehydes and ketones. They have the carbonyl group, a C double bond O, and aldehydes and ketones don't differ from each other very much in their structures, but we'll see a little later on that the reactions are quite different. An aldehyde has the C double bond O and a hydrogen attached to that carbon. A ketone, C double bond O, but on each side are carbon atoms. In other words, it's in the middle of a chain. And you're probably old hands at naming by now. You know that we're going to find the longest chain. We'll change the ending to indicate the functional group that's present. Aldehydes end in AL. Typically, we've gone for the ending of the molecule or the ending of the functional class. But in aldehyde, it would be a little strange, and so they went with the first two letters instead. Ketones, we're back to our typical system where the ending O-N-E is the ending for the IUPAC system. Let's look at an aldehyde and get some practice. Whenever you name an organic compound, look for the functional group. As I look at this structure, I see that C double bond O. It's at the end of the chain. The hydrogen is attached to the carbon. So I say to myself, it's an aldehyde. And then take the rules in the IUPAC system one step at a time. We'll look for the longest chain. We've got a chain of four, so it's going to be derived from butane. We drop the E and change the ending to AL to indicate the presence of the aldehyde functional group. Then we'll number the chain to give the lowest number to the position of the functional group that we can. And an aldehyde is always at the end of the chain. It's always going to be at position one. So we abbreviate it by just leaving out the one. Rather than calling it a 1-butanal, it's simply butanal. Then at position three, the only thing that we haven't named is this methyl group that's sticking up there. So it would be 3-methyl-butanal. Here's another structure. Be tempting to go with this as the longest chain, but it doesn't include the carbon with the functional group. And if we do that, we see again that it's an aldehyde. We want the aldehyde to be as low as possible, so this is going to be position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The base word will be derived from hexane. We'll drop the E ending, change it to an AL, reflecting the aldehyde. And here at position 3, again, we have a methyl group that wasn't included in the name of that longest chain. So it's 3-methylhexanal. Let's look at a ketone. I recognize that this is a ketone because of that C double bond O. It's not at the end of the chain, so it's not an aldehyde. And furthermore, I don't see any hydrogens attached to that carbon, so it's a ketone. Rule number one says to pick the longest chain. And sometimes the longest chain is in the horizontal direction, but in this case, we'd pick up 4 carbons. Then if we drop down 5, 6, and 7, we get a longer chain by taking a little detour. Because the longest chain is 7, it's a modification of heptane, and it's a ketone, so we drop the E of heptane and add O-N-E, it's heptanone. Then rule number two, we'd number the longest chain to get the lowest number for the position of the functional group. If I started over here on the right-hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the C double bond O would be at position 5. If I start from the left, it's at position 3. So 3 wins, it's 3-heptanone. The only puzzle part that we haven't named is this carbon right here with its 3 hydrogens, a methyl group. It's attached to the carbon at position 4. So it's 4-methyl-3-heptanone. Let's look at a cyclic ketone. I've got a 5-membered ring, would be a derivative of cyclopentane. And because it's a ketone, we change the, drop the E and change it to O-N-E, cyclopentanone. Rule number two, number so that you get the lowest number for the position of the functional group. And because it's a ring, we could start numbering anywhere. That means that we'd like position one to be where that C double bond O is. So we could say that it's one cyclopentanone, but because it would always be at position one, typically we leave out that number one. Numbering then to get the lowest number for the position of the group, one, two. At position two, we have an ethyl. So it's 2-ethyl cyclopentanone. Let's look at a third ketone. A little more complex with this ring structure as a component of the molecule. But again, look for the functional group. I see it's a ketone. Look for the longest chain. That's step one. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So the base word will be butanone, dropping the E and adding that O-N-E ending. Again, as a ketone, we've got to locate the position of the C double bond O. Two possible numbering systems, from the left to the right or the right to the left. If I numbered from the right, the C double bond O would be at position 3. So from the left wins. It's a 2-butanone. And then finally, we'll include the puzzle part that we haven't named as a part of the longest chain, a benzene ring. And when it's named as a group on a molecule, it becomes phenyl. So it's 1-phenyl, 2-butanone.